Very good morning to all of you. So in our previous class, we have already discussed the methods of preparation of alcohol. So let us discuss the methods of preparation of phenols. Okay. So the very first method of preparation of phenol is with the help of benzene sulfonic acid. Okay. There are some industrial methods like we have already discussed in the chemical properties of haloalkanes, Dow process. Okay. So Dow process is an industrial method. Okay, we will also discuss that one in the methods of preparation of phenols. Okay, so the very first method is from benzene sulfonic acid. Okay, so firstly we have to prepare benzene sulfonic acid. Okay. So benzene sulfonic acid is prepared by the electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay, electrophilic substitution reaction, like we have already discussed the chlorination. Okay, where we have prepared chlorobenzene. Okay, similar is the case with sulfonic acid. Okay, so we have to take benzene is acting as a nucleophile, so we have to react it with oleum. Okay, oleum is nothing but it is H2SO4 plus SO3, okay, sulfur trioxide. It is this is known as oleum, and the temperature is near about 323 or 353 Kelvin around. Okay, near about 80 degrees Celsius. So then we will get benzene sulfonic acid. Okay, SO3H. Okay. Next step is we have to react it with an alkali so that we will get ONA. Okay, ONA. So actually, in order to make phenol, we have to prepare this compound, sodium phenoxide, so that we can easily convert it into phenol with the help of any acid. Okay, like we have HCl. So it can be easily converted into acid, into phenol, with the help of acid at high temperature. Okay, so so the next step is, and in this case Na2SO3 or water may be they may be the byproducts. Okay, but we have to take this as the next step. Okay, so this is sodium phenoxide. So sodium phenoxide, and we have to react it with HCl. Okay, so that NaCl will leave, and we will get the product. Okay, phenol. We will get phenol. So now this reaction takes place at high temperature, near about 573 Kelvin. Okay. So near about 573 Kelvin. Okay, so this is the first method from benzene sulfonic acid. Firstly, we have to take benzene, react it with oleum. This is sulfonation. Okay, this step is known as sulfonation. Sulfonation, like we have chlorination, bromination, nitration. Similarly, it is sulfonation, and the mechanism is electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay, so SO3H lagega yahan pe, and then we have to react it with alkali to convert it into sodium phenoxide, and then react it with HCl at high temperature to get phenol. Okay, so this is the first method. The second method is from diazonium salt. Okay, so this is very efficient method from diazonium salt. We have already prepared. Okay, one more thing I want to tell you, that we can directly convert phenol into benzene. Okay, we can directly convert phenol into benzene just by reaction with zinc dust plus heat. Okay, we can directly convert phenol into benzene. So we will discuss this one in the chemical properties of phenol later. Okay, so the second method is from diazonium salt. So we have already prepared chlorobenzene from diazonium salt by Sandmeyer and Gaterman reaction. So now we will prepare phenol. Okay, so the steps are very simple. So firstly we have to prepare diazonium salt. We have already prepared it by the reaction of sodium nitrite plus HCl with aniline. Okay, we have to take 2 moles of HCl. Okay, in the first step NaNO2 react with HCl to form nitrous acid, and then nitrous acid plus HCl will react with aniline. Okay, we have already discussed all these things. Okay, then we will get diazonium salt and triple bond and Cl will negative and this nitrogen will have positive charge. Okay, so now just do hydrolysis in presence of any acid, like we have H2SO4. Just do hydrolysis and we will get phenol plus N2 plus HCl. Okay, these two are the byproducts. Okay, so the method is quite efficient because these two are gases, they can easily leave and we will get the main product as phenol. Okay, so this is the second method, and these two methods are very simple. Okay, you can easily memorize these methods. Okay, the third method is by decarboxylation. Okay, and this method is also known as soda lime process, because we have to use the calcium oxide and NaOH both in this reaction. Okay, so the third method is, okay, I think this choke is not working properly. Okay, the third method is by decarboxylation of sodium salt of salicylic acid. Okay, sodium salt of salicylic acid. We have already discussed what is a salicylic acid. Okay, where we have alcohol as well as the acid group. Okay, this is salicylic acid. And now what is the sodium salt? If we replace this hydrogen with Na, then this is the sodium salt, negative charge over here and positive charge over here. This is sodium salicylate. Okay, so now we have to react it with firstly, I have already told you, in order to convert any reactant which you are taken into phenol, you have to first prepare the sodium phenoxide. Okay, so sodium phenoxide, so then we can easily convert it into phenol by a reaction with any acid. Okay, so firstly you have to prepare sodium phenoxide. So now this reaction is also known as soda lime process. Okay, because here we have to take CaO plus NaOH. Okay, so we have to take these two, and in the first step Na2CO3 will leave plus water, and we will get ON. Okay, negative and positive charge. Then you all know what to do, react with HCl. Okay, and NaCl will leave and we will get the product. Okay, we will get the product easily. Okay, one more thing, we have to take 2 moles of NaOH over here. Okay, so that Na2CO3 will leave and water will leave, and we will get sodium phenoxide. Okay, this is the fourth method. The third method. The fourth method is from Grignard reagent. Actually, there are 6 methods. Usually, in most of the textbooks, there are 6 methods or 5 methods. 4 are simple methods and 2 are industrial methods. Okay. So from Grignard reagent. Okay, so firstly the Grignard reagent is this RMgBr. Okay, so firstly we have to react it with oxygen. Okay, to form this compound. This is phenoxy. This group is phenoxy. Okay, this is an ether-like structure. That is why we call it as phenoxy. Phenoxy magnesium bromide. Usually in all the reactions, okay, in 99.9% reactions, where we have taken Grignard reagent, the second step is hydrolysis. Okay, So we have already prepared alcohol with the help of Grignard reagent. There also the first step is the nucleophilic attack of this R group, the R group on the carbon is carbon, and then the double bond will shift over oxygen, and then MgBr will attach with the oxygen, and then we have to do hydrolysis. Okay, so when we do hydrolysis, this MgBr plus OH will leave. Okay, H positive, H2 in the presence of any acid, then MgBr and OH will leave, and the hydrogen which is left attach over here. Okay, and we will get the product as phenol. Okay, so this is the fourth method. Okay, this is the fourth method of preparation. So these are some of the commercial methods. Next we have industrial methods. Okay, so the first method we have already discussed, the dough process. Okay, so the fourth method is dough process. The first method of which is industrial is dough process. So from chlorobenzene. Okay, so industrial process में जो first method है, that is from chlorobenzene. From chlorobenzene. Okay, so the first step is at we have to do this reaction at high temperature, because this is like nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay, so we have to do the nucleophilic substitution reaction, and actually this reaction takes place at high temperature because they are highly unreactive towards nucleophilic substitution reaction. So that is why we have to take high temperature, like 623 Kelvin, and the pressure is 320 atm. Okay, if we want to do this reaction at low temperature, we have to attach some electron withdrawing group, okay, like NO2. Okay, so by the reaction of we cannot convert directly it into phenol, we have to convert it into sodium phenoxide first, like NaOH. okay, so we have to react it with NaOH to form sodium phenoxide, and then simply with HCl, NaCl will leave, and we will get the product. Okay, phenol is the main product. So as simple as that. Okay, so this is the first method, industrial method. The second is from cumene. From cumene. Now this method is quite important, and a lot of questions were asked in the competitive exams also related to this method from cumene. Okay. So in this method we have to boil, we have to raise the temperature first, and then the temperature will lower down. Okay, so the first method is we have to take benzene with propene. We have to react propene with benzene at nearly 523 Kelvin. Okay, so 523 Kelvin, nearly 523 Kelvin. Okay, or 573, near about 523 Kelvin, I think. So now this is cumene. Okay, so this bond will attack over here, and we will get CH3 and one H over here. Okay, so there is also hydrogen over here. That hydrogen will attach to this carbon, and this double bond will break. Okay, this is cumene. Okay, this is cumene, and the next step is the aryl oxidation. Okay, next step is aryl oxidation, and the temperature will become low, and near about 380 Kelvin. Okay, so 380 Kelvin ke kareeb hoga temperature, 380 to 400. Okay, so aryl oxidation bolte hain ise. Aryl oxidation. Okay, so and we get this product. Okay, here we will get two oxygen and CH3. Okay, this is the product. Here we have carbon, and O2 will enter into this bond, this CH bond. Okay, so next step is just heating. Okay, heating, and we will get the product. And the main thing is the byproduct. Okay, we will get CH3 C double bond O CH3 acetone as the byproduct. Okay, acetone or propanone. Okay, so by heating in presence of I think H3PO4. Okay, so and the temperature is even more low. It is near about 330 Kelvin. Okay, so now this hole will leave as a byproduct. Okay, and here we will get double bond, and this OH will attach over here. Okay, in the presence of H3PO4, this reaction will take place. Okay, so this is the whole steps of this particular method. The first step is the reaction of benzene with propene, and we will get cumene, C-U-M-E-N-E, at high temperature near about 523 Kelvin, and then by aerial oxidation the O2 will enter into this CH bond, and we will get oxycumene. This is known as oxycumene, and then on heating in presence of H3PO4 we will get phenol, and the byproduct is acetone. So this question was also asked in a competitive exam, I think in NEET 2018 or 19, that when we prepare phenol with the help of cumene, what is the byproduct we get? Okay, so this was the question which was asked in NEET, and the byproduct is acetone. Okay, so there are four options in which acetone is one of the option, acetone or propanone. Okay, so this is the question. Okay, so a lot of questions are asked from the chemical properties also. Okay, and from the methods of preparation of alcohols and phenols. Okay, so let us discuss the chemical. Firstly, we have to discuss the physical properties of alcohol and phenol. So let's move on to the physical properties of alcohol and phenol. So the first is physical state. Physical state. So we have to discuss two or three basic properties. Okay, basic physical property. The first is physical state. Okay, so generally all the alcohols of lower member or even higher member are liquids. Okay, but lower members are generally colorless, like we have methanol and ethanol. So all the lower members of alcohols are colorless, and they have some burning like smell. Okay, so all the lower members of alcohols are colorless. Even methanol is highly poisonous. Okay, methanol is highly poisonous, and usually the bottles of ethanol also contain around 1 or 2% of methanols. Okay, which we are using in our labs. Okay, it will contain 1 or 2% of methanol also. Okay, in case of if we talk about phenols are generally solids. Okay, the higher members are solids, so phenols are liquids as well as solids. So small members are liquids as well as solids. Okay, actually it will depend upon the weather. Okay, it will depend upon the weather whether they exist as solid or liquid. In winter season, so phenols usually freezes. Okay, and we have to heat the bottle. Okay, phenol is kept in a glass bottle. Okay, so we have to heat the bottle in order to convert it into liquid and to use it as a solvent. Okay, or some other experiment. So phenol is used in a lot of experiments. Okay, so I have also used phenol in a experiment, and usually in November or December month. So the bottle, the phenol freeze. So we have I have to heat the bottle. Okay, so in order to convert it into liquid. Okay, so generally they will also acquire some color in winter season. Okay, so when we heat them, they will become colorless. Okay, so this is the first property, the physical state. The second is their boiling point. Their boiling point. Okay, so their boiling point is very higher than that of alkyl halides because their bonds are highly polar in nature, and the main cause of their high boiling point is they can easily form hydrogen bonding. Okay, so they have high boiling point due to the formation of hydrogen bonding. So due to the formation of hydrogen bonding, they have high boiling point. Okay, so and the boiling point is inversely proportional to the length. The length. Okay, so because generally क्या होता है, as the number of members increases, the strength of boiling point decreases. Okay, the strength of boiling point decreases. So the boiling point of higher members are usually low. Okay, and the boiling point of higher members are high because boiling point is I think directly proportional to molecular mass. Okay, so you can write it as, and ठीक है मैंने शायद उल्टा बोल दिया, boiling point is directly proportional to molecular mass. Okay, so as the molecular mass increases, the boiling point will also increase, and as the branches increases, the boiling point will decrease. Okay, so boiling point is inversely proportional to the branches. Okay, it means primary have the highest boiling point, followed by secondary, and then we have tertiary. Like if we talk about the four member, we have n-butanol. Okay, so इसका boiling point जो होगा वो सबसे ज़्यादा. Then we have, if I talk about this compound, this is secondary, then iska hoga, and then we have the tertiary. The last one is tertiary. We have the lowest boiling point. So as the branches increases or the surface area decrease, okay, so the boiling point will also decrease. Okay, so this is the second thing, and there are two. As the number of OH groups increases, the boiling point increases because more will be the extent of hydrogen bonding. Okay, so as the number of OH groups increase, the boiling point will also increase. Like in case of ethylene glycol, and if we talk about triglycerides, okay, so they have a high boiling point because there are two or three OH groups present. So the extent of hydrogen bonding will also increase. So in case of phenol also have high boiling point because it can also easily form hydrogen bond. Okay, so okay, I will show you the hydrogen bonding. Like we have this compound phenol, so it can easily form hydrogen bond with the other oxygen atom of phenol. Okay, and actually they also exist as associate molecules. Okay, they will also form aggregates, like in case of we have alcohols. Okay, so alcohols will also form hydrogen bonding like this. This hydrogen will form hydrogen bonding with the other molecule. Again, this hydrogen can easily form hydrogen bonding with the other molecule, and so on so forth. Okay, so they will form a huge giant molecules. They will form a huge structure, or they will form aggregates. Okay, so that is why their boiling point is very high. Okay, so as the number of OH groups increases, the extent of hydrogen bonding increases. Okay, the boiling point will increase. As the molar mass increases, the boiling point increase. Okay, in case of state chain, and if the branching increases, the boiling point will decrease. Okay, so the third property is solubility. Okay, solubility. So generally the solubility in if we talk about the solubility in water, they can easily soluble in water. Okay, so the third property is solubility. okay, this is the okay, this is the last property, solubility. Okay, so they can easily form hydrogen bond with water and are highly soluble in water. Okay, actually like dissolved like the concept of water is also polar, and that is why it can easily dissolve in alcohols because both are polar in nature. Okay, the second reason is the hydrogen bond. Okay, so they can easily form hydrogen bond like we have methanol. They can easily form hydrogen bond. This will form hydrogen bond with the water, and again this hydrogen can easily form hydrogen bond with the oxygen atom of this molecule. Okay, so they can easily form hydrogen bond. Okay, so but the solubility decreases. Okay, the solubility decreases as the molecular mass increases. Okay, so the solubility will decrease as the molecular mass or the number of hydrocarbon part increases. Okay, so as the hydrocarbon part increases the solubility will decrease. Okay, so that is why as we go from methanol to ethanol, propanol, the solubility of water solubility with water decreases. Similarly, phenol, in case of phenol, there is already a very large hydrocarbon part, there are 6 carbon atoms. Okay, so that is why its solubility is even more less than that of alcohols. Okay, because here already 6 membered carbon ring is present. Okay, so the more the hydrocarbon part, the less will be the solubility. Okay, actually this hydrocarbon part also create a obstacle. Okay, this hydrocarbon part also create a obstacle in hydrogen bonding. Okay, this hydrocarbon part create a obstacle in hydrogen bonding, so that is why the solubility will decrease. Okay, so this is all about the main three physical properties: solubility, boiling point, and the physical state. Okay, so there are many physical properties, but these three are the main physical properties. Okay, so now alcohols and phenols are used as a very as a solvent in many of the experiments, like ethanol. Okay, ethanol is used as a very used in very very large amount. Okay, because its boiling point is generally 70 to 80 degrees Celsius, and most of the products are formed under these temperatures. Okay, I have also prepared a product known as Schief base. Okay, Schief base, SC. I have also done a project on Schief base in order to prepare Schief base. Schief bases are generally they are antibacterial. They are used as antibiotics also. So in the preparation of Schief base, I have used ethanol as the solvent. Okay, because generally the compound which is formed at near about 60 to 70 degrees Celsius. Okay. I use microwave synthesis. Okay, I use microwave, not any other method. Like we have round bottom flask, we can use the distillation process also. But in case of microwave, the product can be formed within you can say 15 or 20 minutes. Okay, but in case of RBF, in case of round bottom flask, it will take 1 or 2 days. Okay, so you have time, you have a bahut hi यह कि कंज्यूम कम होता है. ओके, एंड बट देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ रिस्क इन केस ऑफ माइक्रोवेव बिकॉज द बाउल कैन इजीली ब्रेक. ओके, यू हैव टू चेक इट टाइम टू टाइम. इफ द टेम्परेचर और द सॉल्वेंट विल कंप्लीटली इवेपोरेट, देन द बाउल विल ब्रेक. ओके, सो दैट इज व्हाई इथेनॉल इज यूज्ड एज अ सॉल्वेंट. सो आई यूजली यूज इथेनॉल और समटाइम्स द अदर सॉल्वेंट्स ऑल्सो देयर. सो बट इथेनॉल जो है वो मेरा काम इजिली कर देता था बिकॉज मैं यूज थोड़ा एक्सेस में करता था उसे, ताकि इफ आई इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर देन देयर इज सम अमाउंट ऑफ इथेनॉल विल लेफ्ट, ताकि वो जो बीकर है वो बस्ट ना. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द physical properties of alcohols and phenol. Now in the next class we will discuss the chemical properties. Okay, chemical properties of alcohols and phenols. Okay, now in case of if we talk about alcohols, so this bond can easily cleave and this bond can also easily cleave. So the chemical properties are divided into two parts based on which bond will cleave. Okay, so there are some chemical properties related to this bond cleavage and some properties related to this bond cleavage. Okay, so we will discuss them also. Okay, so I think this much is quite enough for this particular lecture, and I hope you found this lecture very helpful, and thank you so much for watching.